Hi, I'm John. This is my show, An American Scheme, where I am proving that Diana Ross is Michael Jackson's actual mother. So this video, this is some things I've talked about a lot and stuff and things that have come up recently. But I just wanted to add a couple little things to it and just kind of throw together this cool little video and stuff, right? So this is, I show this a lot, right? So this is the Diana Ross on the Merv Griffin show in 1970. And this is when Michael's alone in the audience there with her. And she calls him her child. So let me show you this real quick.
Well, we have one of them in the audience here with us.
Where?
We have Michael Jackson somewhere out there. Is he out there? Where is he? There he is. That's my child.
Hey.
That's Michael.
Okay, so I wanted to show you that part because I wanted to also make sure you understood that. See the dress that she's wearing? Because I'm going to show you a performance now where she's performing at this, when she was doing this here on the Merv Griffin show. She didn't just do an interview. She also sang and did performances, okay? So I wanted to make it clear that you people understood that this is the same performance right there where she was, Michael's there alone. Okay, so now I want to show you. Now this is her performing. See, you could tell it's the same dress that she's, it's the same show. I wanted to make that clear. That's why I had to show you that first part so that you would understand that this is that same show. Okay, so listen what she says right here. She's singing Ain't No Mountain High Enough, okay? So listen here. You see, because that's where Michael was sitting over there, where she's singing. She's singing to Michael, and she pointed over there. She pointed over to there, and she says, just remember the day I set you free, okay? Because she's talking about, she's telling Michael, you know? She's like singing this to him, and she points to him, saying, remember the day I set you free? I told you there ain't no mountain high enough to keep me from you. You know, but she set him free because this is the story and what's going on. Like she said, she called him a child, but here she is back with him now and she's feeling all joyous. This is 1970, so this is early within their reuniting together, you know, and she's got him there alone. She's singing Ain't No Mountain High Enough. She says, remember the day I set you free? Just remember, Ain't No Mountain High Enough. But then now I wanted you to see because it's, I wanted you to clearly understand that he's, that Michael was there when she was singing that to him, okay? Now, when you go to the video for Leave Me Alone, now you gotta remember, this is after Thriller, so Michael's become the biggest star in the world, right? So now he's doing Bad album, and he's got the song Dirty Diana on there, but he's also got Leave Me Alone, which Leave Me Alone is him telling Diana to leave him alone, okay? So like this line here, don't you come walking, begging back, mama. I don't care anyway. Michael's attitude has changed. His thing between him and Diana Ross, he's now like went way beyond it. And he's like, this is like, he's stepping into his own now. He's becoming his own man. And he's like saying, he's calling her Dirty Diana. And he's making sure that she understands that he knows and he feels the pain of being left by her. And all of this stuff, even though that she's come walking, begging back, mama, you know, he's, I don't care anyway. He's telling her, just leave me alone, right? He's freaking going off on her on this song and shit, right? So then you get up to this line here. Ain't no mountain that I can't climb, baby. All's going my way. See, he's like, all that ain't no mountain high enough stuff, screw you. Ain't no mountain that I can't climb, baby, because it's going my way. It's going my way now. It's about him, right? I'll play this a little bit here. Ain't no mountain. Who's laughing now, right? As he's the biggest star in the world, right? He's just straight going off on her. And to use that line about there ain't no mountain that I can't climb, baby, it's like he's throwing that right back in her face because of that performance that I just showed you where she's singing there ain't no mountain high enough to him, right? He's just fully going off on her. And it's the choice that we make and this choice you will take. just straight leave me alone. He just straight going off on her. Leave me alone. It's like people think this is about the media. This ain't about the media. This is about him and Diana. It's like, what is his inspirations? The real inner feelings that get him to be saying this stuff. It's really sad. We get to this point. It's one of these things where I talk about, like, I want to mention, like, Nicholas Stohler the other day, because he freaking pissed me off. I mean, I have no respect for him anymore. I just, like, what a loser. Because he came to the, he's like, saying, oh, I believe your story, yes. But then he says, then he comes up with a line, and this is the line that when people say this, it's just like, okay, I've lost all respect for you now and stuff, right? So Nicholas Stohler said to me, who cares who Michael Jackson's real parents are anyways? Who cares? Oh, maybe Michael Jackson cares? And you, like I keep saying, you just proved yourself to be the fake fan of what I keep saying, that these fans are all out here, fake fans just stealing from Michael Jackson. When they say that line, who cares who Michael Jackson's real parents are anyways? Who cares? That's what freaking like Matt's FTR, who cares? Who cares about that anyways? Who cares? Michael Jackson cared. But you don't care about Michael Jackson. All you care about is stealing from Michael Jackson. That's why I keep yelling, you guys are fake fans. You're fake as fuck, man. Leave me alone. Michael had to go through this shit. This is what he wrote his fucking songs about. And you don't care? You don't think it fucking matters? Fucking loser motherfuckers. Stop it. Just stop dogging me around. Because what is Diana Ross? She always bring in Michael. Oh, look at, this is my child. Oh, look at, he's going to play my son. All this stuff, that's what she was doing. Like a dog, like on a leash, dragging him around like he's just some dog. Stop it. Just stop dogging me around. You're not going to walk around with me like your little pet dog no more. Michael stepped up and said, fuck that shit. You leave me alone. I don't care about your fucking, ain't no mountain that I can't climb now, baby. Frickin' Michaels, everything's going my way. And you motherfuckers don't care about this shit? God damn. You guys are fucking losers. This is, when you people say, who cares who Michael Jackson's parents are? It's like, hey, dude, this is what his fucking songs are about. And you claim to be a Michael Jackson fan? You can't see what the pain and the fucking heartache and the inspiration that he draw from to put this in his music? This is obviously the most important thing to Michael Jackson. But you don't care! Motherfucking loser fans and shit. So, this is the poem, let me show you this first. Okay, so, who will dance on the floor in the round? Okay, in the Billie Jean song, Diana Ross's Billie Jean, this is all about the same stuff. Who will dance on the floor in the round? So this is the poem by Robert Frost called The Secret Sits.
The Secret Sits by Robert Frost. We dance round a ring and suppose, but the secret sits in the middle and knows.
This is Michael Jackson, the artist, you know, and what he did with his stuff, with who will dance on the floor in the round. We danced around a circle and supposed, but the secret sits in the middle and knows. The secret sits in the middle and knows. What's the secret? The secret of what's sitting in the middle of this is that Diana Ross is Billie Jean, that Diana Ross is informing Michael Jackson that she's his real mother when he's living in her house after they signed to Motown and he's hanging out with her alone, just like I just showed you on the video when they're at the Merv Griffin thing, that's what's going on. That's the secret. So, now, there's more to it. Now, Robert Frost. Okay, so this is Robert Frost. Robert Frost, born. His birthday is March 26, okay? The secret sits in the middle. Diana Ross. Birthday, March 26th. They've got the same birthday. Robert Frost and Diana Ross have the same birthday. What's the secret? It's about Diana Ross. The secret sits. Who's the secret? Diana Ross is the secret. Sitting in the middle. Diana Ross and Robert Frost have the same birthday. Now, Billie Jean. Now, this is right as the part, this is up to the moment he's going to come up to that billboard where it says the story of, it says Luisa on the billboard. So I'm going to show you like right here. Here's the clip. Right as he, and now listen to the words that he says. Right as he comes up to the point where they're going to start showing that billboard, what's the part of the song that Michael Jackson is singing?
So my strong advice, just remember to always think twice.
Right there, he totally looked at the billboard too. Watch as he, so just remember, take my strong advice. Just remember to always think twice. Watch. See right there? Look at how he, don't think twice, do think twice. Look at how he's staring at the billboard. Right after he comes out of his spin, he's dead focused on the billboard. Look at that. Dead focused on the billboard, right? So right as he's telling you, he's looking at the billboard and he's telling you to think twice. Take my strong advice, just remember to always think twice. While he's looking dead center at the billboard with the name Luisa on it, right? Luisa is the story of Luisa by Diana Ross. Story of Luisa by Diana Ross. Just like I keep saying, everything, it's all there. It's clearly, blatantly obvious what's taking place here. But when are you going to get some real Michael Jackson fans who are going to start talking about this and telling? And stop, not only telling, fighting, stop fighting against me, you pathetic, loser, fake Michael Jackson fans. Because right now, the way it comes out is like, my story is going to come out. I could show you other stuff too that's going on. I was going to make another video, but I should have put that in this video too, the one little thing. But my story's coming out, and here, actually, I'm gonna go show you something here really quick. That's the She Says I Am Her Son. Now, I think I put this in this one. I'll just show you, like, these are like all the videos I got.
Could be part of my family.
Yeah. Could be part of my family.
We have a lot of the same bone
structure. We have a lot of the same bone structure. Like, this is stuff, it's like just ridiculous, the amount of stuff of what I've got. But let me see. Yeah, here it is. So there's a video here.
If you suffer from diabetes type 2 or diabetes, this might be the most important video you ever watched.
Okay.
Hey guys, I wanted to warn you that during this video you might hear like a staticky.
This is a girl named Ashley SaysSo, and this is Old Hollywood Scandals, Diana Ross, okay? Now, she talks about, you go through it, she's all talking about Diana Ross stuff, and, you know, the whole thing, it's all about Diana Ross. It's a pretty good video and stuff, right? But then you get to the end, you get to the very end. Let's go ahead and play it from here, let's see.
This is a doozy, and I believe that it's fake. It really sounds stupid to me, but y'all know that when I read gossip and tea, I include it all in this video so we can talk about it in the comments. All right, the last big doozy of tea that I have is that some people in the world, for whatever reason, believe and have put a rumor out that Michael Jackson is the child of Diana Ross and Smokey Robinson. I know. Then the people get so messy that when you confront these people with the other gossip of, okay, well then I thought y'all said that Diana Ross and Michael Jackson was messing around. Well, yeah, that's true too. He just didn't know he was messing with his mama. Now that just sounds stupid. And I'm sorry to even tell y'all that, but y'all know when y'all tune into this channel, y'all tune in for all of it, no matter how ridiculous.
Okay, so this is what I'm showing you, is that the story's out. It's out in a way that this girl has heard the story. She's talking and having conversations with other people, but not me. She's talking with me. So this experience that she had I was not even a part of it. Except that I'm the one that created this story, right? This is my story. This is my investigation. So if she wants to get clarity about the situation and have better understanding of this stuff, you have to talk to me, okay? This girl, she's got her, she's paid, she's got 80,000. She's got 80,000 subscribers on her page. This video has almost 200,000 views, okay? And it's like, It's just, this is what I'm saying to you. It's like the story's evolved and it's out there. I mean, there was in the Mirror, got reported. It was in Rolling Stone. I mean, they got talked about because James L. did a lot of work and stuff and helped and stuff. But that's the thing. This rumor is like, it's out there now. It's an official rumor that's out there. But the people, they're not talking to me. And so she could sit there and say, oh, this sounds stupid, whatever. But it's not me. You're not me. You don't have the information. You can't, you don't know the research of what I've done. You don't know what evidence I have. So of course it's going to sound stupid to you because you don't know anything about the actual story. Of course it's going to sound stupid to you, but it's just funny, as I will show you. It's like, look at this, is out there. This girl's not, doesn't, she don't know who the hell I am, but she's heard my story, which is funny because you people that come around who know me and the people know that I'm the one that started the story. But what I'm showing you is the story's got its own life now. It's out there, but they don't know. And then what happens is, and she tries to get clarity to the story and ask these people that are not me, who don't actually understand it, then they're going to say stupid shit and they're going to fuck it all up. And that's what they do. They keep fucking it all up. It's like, look it, if you want the answers, you have to talk to me. I'm the only one who can literally answer like everything, because I've been challenged by the people who have challenged me. So it's forced me to come up with explanations. So now there's a few people out there that can talk about it and try and do good and stuff, but they're not me. They can't clarify everything they have. They haven't had, they're not me. They haven't had to deal with people coming at them and have had to deal with learning how to give explanations for these things and having to find the evidence. And so that's how I just wanted to show you this part too. That's like, look at, it's just, it's hilarious and stuff. It's like, look at, the story's out. Why are you people fighting against it, trying to act like it's not out? It's out. It's out. It's got its own life. What I did this, and you people that are around, it's like, dude, you've got the opportunity to speak with me. Hear it from the horse's mouth. Me. I'm the freaking horse's mouth. I'm the one that's got clarity to all of this situation because I created the fucking story. I've done the investigation. I show you the evidence. There ain't no doubt about it. This is true. But the people like this, they can't figure it out. They don't know that Diana Ross was sleeping in Smokey Robinson's house. They don't know that stuff. Like this stuff, she was talking about all this stuff and Diana Ross's relationships and stuff. It was all good, some good information and stuff, but she didn't know that Diana Ross was sleeping in Smokey Robinson's house. She doesn't know that. That was one big part, that she doesn't know that. And once she learns that and understands, look at, that happened right as Motown was developing. That happened before Diana Ross got into the primes and was hanging around with like Eddie Kendricks and stuff like that. It was before all the Motown stuff. Before all of the relationships that develop in the Motown stuff, Diana Ross is sleeping in Smokey Robinson's house and she's in love with him at the exact time of which Michael Jackson's actually conceived, which is right after Smokey Robinson met Berry Gordy and they started working together. That's how it all happened. That's the timing of how it all worked. And then you see how everything actually plays out in history, plays out just how I says it, how I say it plays out. I've got the facts to back it up. I got the documents. There's no doubt about it. Michael Jackson documented it in his freaking songs. I explain the songs now. Once you know the truth, now you can actually start understanding Michael Jackson's art. But that's not important. Who cares about that? That's what all the stupid fake fan losers say.